This is part 3 of solving rational equations. And remember, a fraction is undefined if 0 is in the denominator. Here's another problem. Solve x over x plus 12 equals 1 over x plus 5. Before solving this, let's just pay attention to the denominators. Remember, the denominators cannot be equal to 0. So note, so we don't forget, x plus 12 cannot be equal to 0, which is to say x cannot be negative 12. Okay? Also, the other denominator, x plus 5, cannot be equal to 0, so x can't be negative 5. So basically, x cannot be negative 12 and it cannot be negative 5. All right? Just got to keep that in mind. All right, so we've been solving these by multiplying both sides by the least common denominator, which in this case would be x plus 12 times x plus 5. The other way I told you to do it is you could make all the denominators the same. So we could sort of use the jealousy method here. So let's make the denominators on both sides of the equation x plus 12 times x plus 5. So this first fraction, x over x plus 12, to get it so it has the least common denominator, I'm going to multiply it by x plus 5 over x plus 5. So I'm just making an equivalent fraction. Now on the right hand side, I have an x plus 5. It has to have the same denominator, so I need to multiply it by x plus 12 over x plus 12. Okay, now both fractions on both sides of the equation have the same denominator, so the numerators must be equal. That's one way of thinking about it. Or you could say, well, if I now multiply both sides by x plus 12 times x plus 5, it will cancel both denominators. So if you want, you can do that as well. I'm going to just make the numerators equal. And you can only do this if it's an equation. So if both denominators are equal, then the numerators should also be equal. In other words, I'm going to write that over here. If a over d equals b over c, and we don't have any zeros in the denominator, then, I'm sorry, I meant to write b over d, same denominator, then it should make sense to you that a and b must be the same number. All right, so that's what I'm doing here. So x times x plus 5, this numerator on the left-hand side, must be the same as the numerator on the right-hand side, since they were both over the same denominator. All right, so now what do we have here? We've got to simplify the left-hand side, x squared plus 5x equals x plus 12. All right, so we've simplified both sides. Now, we have to analyze this equation. It's different than problems we've done so far. We have an x squared term. This is a quadratic. This will be a quadratic equation. And how do you solve a quadratic equation? You have to set it equal to 0. Factor, then set each factor equal to 0 and solve. So I need to subtract x and subtract 12 from both sides. So I have x squared plus 5x. I need to subtract x and subtract 12 from both sides. So I have x squared plus 4x minus 12 equals 0. It's not going to work to try to get the variables on one side and constants on the other because of the x squared term. All right, now I have a quadratic equation, and I've set the quadratic equal to 0, so I factor. All right, now I've gone over factoring in lots of different videos that you can do on scratch paper somewhere, and hopefully you will get the same factors I'm going to get here. All right, so we need factors that multiply out to be negative 12 and have a difference of 4. I think that's 6 and 2. We're going to have a plus 6 and a minus. Let's see if that's correct. If we do the FOIL method, I have x squared. Outer term is negative 2x. Inner term is plus 6x. That does give a plus 4x. And the last term is negative 12. So that's the correct factorization. So x plus 6 times x minus 2 equals 0. That's our next step. We set each factor equal to 0, because if either of these factors equals 0, then it's going to be a true equation. So either x plus 6 can equal 0, or Another possibility is x minus 2 equals 0. Alright, so we finally can solve. Okay, before going further, let's remember what we did at the beginning. We said what x cannot be. So look up here in the right-hand corner. X cannot be negative 12 or negative 5. Okay, great. I didn't get a negative 12 or a negative 5. So hopefully these are the correct solutions. We've got two solutions. That means we have to check one at a time. There's going to be two checks. So we're going to check this one first. Let's check negative 6 in the original. And what was the original? X over x plus 12 was equal to 1 over x plus 5. So we're going to check x equals negative 6. All right, so we're going to plug in negative 6 for x. So I have negative 6 over negative 6 plus 12. That's going to give you negative 6 over 6, and that's going to simplify to negative 1. If I just kind of go down the page here. And on the right-hand side, I'm going to plug in negative 6 for x. Remember, you can't put 2 in for one of the x's and negative 6 for the other. You're just checking negative 6 for all the x's to begin with. So we're going to put in 1 over negative 6 plus 5 is 1 over negative 1, and 1 divided by negative 1 is negative 1. So it checks. So you know what? X equals negative 6 does check. That's going to be one possible solution. Now we're going to check x equals 2 into the original. Right, so we're going to plug in positive 2. We've got Alright, so we've got 2 over 2 plus 12, which is 2 fourteenths, and that's 1 seventh. Alright, that's the left-hand side. And now on the other side of the equation, we're going to plug in 2 for x, and that's 1 seventh. So when I plugged in 2, I got 1 seventh on both sides of the equation, so 2 is also a solution. So this original problem has two solutions, negative 6 and 2. Oops. Negative 6 is a solution, 2 is a solution. Now, there are two solutions. This is not an ordered pair. I'm not putting anything in parentheses. There's not an x and a y. There's two different things that x could be to make this equation true. So you're incorporating a lot of ideas in this one problem. Right? Let's go back. Okay, where do we start? Solve. So we started off with a rational equation. We determined what x could not be because the denominators cannot be equal to 0. We cleared through the fractions to get x times x plus 5 equals x plus 12. Now we could have also done this by multiplying both sides by x plus 5 times x plus 12 and you would get exactly the same equation. Then we had a quadratic. Right, after we simplified both sides, and then we had to remember how to solve a quadratic, and then we had to check our answers, and that's how we finally got the solution. So boy, this really brings a lot of ideas from algebra together. And that's all I could do on this video. So again, the trick is to make sure that you go through step by step, making sure that you don't have a zero in the denominator. You have to remember how to solve equations, how to clear through the denominators by multiplying by the least common denominator, etc. And check your answers. So you might want to practice this one on your own. Just turn off this video, try it all on your own, and see if you end up with the same answer.